Okay, so 10 habits of fit women over 40. Number one, strength training. It is so super important that you are building lean muscle in your workouts because lean muscle mass makes your metabolism high and makes you burn lots of calories at rest. Now, we lose a lot of lean muscle mass once we hit over the age of 30. So it's really important that you reverse that by doing strength training a few times a week. The second one is to not rely on cardio. There is far too many women coming to me telling me they're not getting results and they're running on the road. They're in the gym doing the treadmill or the cross trainer only and they're not getting any results. And you simply can't rely on cardio to get you results. You have to do strength training and you have to mix that up with some interval training. So forget those long, steady state cardio for good results. The third thing is to stop obsessing over the number on the weighing scales. The weighing scales can't tell whether you have muscle on your body or whether you have fat. So when you're working out and eating healthy and you've got lean muscle mass on your body, the weighing scales don't actually know that you're fit and healthy and fitting great in your clothes. So forget that number on the scales and remember that muscle, it weighs more than fat. So the slimmer you are, the harder it is to see what you want to see on the weighing scales. So don't use the weighing scales for tracking your progress. Use something else. Next up is to eat real food. It's really important that you eat from all food groups. Dieting and omitting different food groups isn't going to get you anywhere. That might have worked in an unhealthy way in your 20s, but it's certainly not going to help you once you hit 40 and beyond. And it's really important that you focus on your health and nourishment rather than just dieting and omitting stuff out. And the next one is to avoid calorie counting or weighing your food or counting or doing points or weighing anything that you eat. It can get you down a very obsessive rabbit hole of obsession, and you don't need that because all that's going to do is make you not want to do it anymore. Remember, focus on eating healthy and omitting the junk, the alcohol during the week, but you're focusing on the healthy food, 3 meals, 2 snacks. The next thing is to stop being so hard on yourself because you're going to keep going around in circles if you only focus on all the things that you're not doing what you think you should be doing. So try to get your wins and your momentum from focusing on all the things that you're doing right. And you'll find that you'll break your plateau, you'll stop cycling and you'll actually make progress. The next thing is to work out and eat healthy because you love yourself, not because you hate yourself. And if you find that you're eating healthy because you hate yourself, because you're calling yourself fat and all that sort of stuff, then it's time to work on the self-love part while you're working out and eating healthy. And the next thing is to listen to your body. Especially as we get older, we can get more tired, stress can get to us, life can become more stressful. So listen to your body, rest when you need rest, get to bed at a good time, don't scroll on your phone, and take care of yourself. And the second last thing is that fitness is a lifestyle choice. So you should be having fun and a laugh. Don't be going into your workouts the whole time, beating yourself up and hating on yourself and thinking you should do better. Try and enjoy it because life is short and it's a lifestyle choice. So you want to be happy and motivated doing it. And the last thing is to embrace the discomfort. Don't worry sometimes if you're sitting on the couch at night and you fancy having a crisps and chocolate and you feel uncomfortable and you're wondering, oh, is this just me? Why am I craving that? Don't worry about all that stuff and embrace discomfort in your workouts too. Everything that's tougher to get, the harder the climb is more rewarding. So keep up the good work. You can do it. And I promise you, you'll be feeling good if you follow these tips in no time at all.